I'm Varda Sharma, editor Newsband, daily English newspaper of Navi Mumbai. Today we have with us Shivani Agarwalla, who has the distinction of being India's first woman world champion in kettlebell sports, which was held in Bukhara, Uzbekistan in 2018. She also has the honor of being India's only two-time woman world championship champion in the same sports. Hi, welcome Shivani.
Thank you, Varda. It's a pleasure being here. Thank you so much for having me over.
Shivani, first of all, I would like to know, I mean, we would really know what exactly is kettlebell sports, because I think this is a relatively lesser known sports in India. And secondly, Absolutely. Why and when did you think of taking this up?
Great. So first I'll start with the second half of your question, because that is more dear to me. I started the entire idea of lifting kettlebells only with the thought of losing my postpartum weight. So I'm a mother to a 6-year-old today. As we speak, my son has turned 6. And so I incidentally got the membership of a club in the year 2015. And my husband has always been, keen on fitness and living a certain type of a lifestyle, which is so-called healthy. So after I delivered my son in 2015, I had a little bit of postpartum weight. So he said, why don't you join the gym? And I, for one, was a completely non-sporty person, completely from a non-fitness background. And I was hitting the gym for the first time in my life. So I said, well, let's give it a try. So there I chanced upon this beautiful sport called kettlebell. There at the club, I met my coach and my mentor, Mr. Arnav Sarkar, who introduced me to the beautiful sport. Back then, I used to pursue it just as a recreation, just to add a little bit of a variety to my gym training. Mm-hmm. And with a very small son back in the house, he was almost a little more than one. And with my work schedule, since I am a practicing chartered accountant, we are dealing with a lot of numbers through the day, and with an ever traveling husband, because we get to see him only 5 to 6 days in a month, I thought this is not my cup of tea and I called it quits. And then luck had it that my coach gave me a call one fine Sunday afternoon in the month of May. He said, I wish to train you, and if you're willing enough, I will come down and train you. And that's how I began my journey. So the idea even back then was just to pursue it as something which can help you lose weight, fitness. You must be seeing a lot of videos of Kareena Kapoor and a lot of these other women who are lifting kettlebells for fitness. He probably saw the spark in me, and then he made me appear for my first international competition at Malaysia in 2017. And that's it. That's how it all began.
Shivani.
And to let you know what kettlebell is.
Yes.
Well, kettlebell. Yes, Varda. So it's basically a weight which looks like a kettle, and hence it's called a kettlebell. It's a repetitive sport in the sense that you have to lift the bell in a certain pattern for a span of, say, 30 minutes, 10 minutes or 1 hour, depending on the format you're competing in. And depending on the number of repetitions you gather in that particular lift, that's how you know how well you fare. I mean, I do a lift called a snatch. So you need to lift the bell in a certain way, bring it down, and you need to continuously keep doing that for a span of, say, 10 minutes or half an hour. Very popular back in Russia, and Now it's gaining a lot of momentum around India also.
It's very interesting to know that you were not at all a sports enthusiast, and then you took up the sport. And so how was your first, if you can just recall, how was your first international event, and what challenges or how stiff was the competition?
So let me tell you, Varda, I belong to a very conservative family. My parents are the best parents one can have. But for the lack of a better term, I would say they were conservative back in those days. So when I first told them that I am participating in a sporting competition, A, for a girl to travel abroad alone, unescorted, was unheard of. And secondly, that too for a sporting event, that came as a bit of a shock, if I may say, for the entire family. But the one guy who stood like rock with me was my husband. He said, go for it, try it out and see what you get. And I still have very vivid recollection of the memories because my brother was sent as an escort with me. That, you know, what if I get lost in the streets of Malaysia? And obviously, I was nervous because back in school, I've never even participated in March Past. And here I was, you know, participating in an international competition. That was an Asian championship, which was held in 2017 in Malaysia. And obviously, I had a lot of butterflies in my stomach. And I just went for the idea of getting an experience. I was not even wearing my proper lifting shoes, you know. The idea was to go see how it is and then, you know, learn from the experience. And I think that's always been the case with me. Even in my chartered accountancy profession, when I first appeared at the tribunal, when I was working with someone, my boss just sent me. I did not even know that the tribunal, you have to have a, you know, a dress code. Like you have to be dressed in black and white. So I think life is just, you know, as they say, when life gives you lemons, make lemonade out of it. So I think that's how it works for me.
As you have mentioned that at that time, the sports was in India, it was lesser known. So there must have been dearth of infrastructure and other training facilities. So what challenges did you face?
Varda, yes, I cannot deny. You know, we live in a country where people love sports, but there's, you know, the love and the loyalty is skewed towards specific sports only. Obviously, topping it is cricket, and people do not see beyond that particular sport as something, you know. Even today, when I talk about the sport to people, most of them land up pronouncing it as kettleball instead of kettlebell. I still have people, my own, you know, my kin. I would not say my immediate family, but people mocking me that, you know, what is this kettlebell? And, you know, I mean, we've never heard of it. But I still face that. And obviously, I am very sensitive to the sport. And my coach always tells me that when the sport has given you so much, it's time for you to give it back. So, yes, there is a lot of awareness that needs to be created. And hence, a lot of local channels in Calcutta, like the News 24 Bangla, the Ananda Bazar Postrika, they've done articles to popularize the sport. Talking of infrastructure, I would say, no offense, men, but today in Calcutta, when I need to run about 20 kilometers a week for my assistance training, I don't have a good park to go for a run. Like, I don't know who is hearing me, but yes, there is a lot of development in terms of infrastructure that we need. But with kettlebell sport, the good part about the sport is, Varda, that you can also train in your room. All you need is your lifting gear, you need a mat, and you need your belt. So honestly speaking, you don't look out much in terms of infrastructure and support. And when you don't get it, probably you just learn to live with what you have. So I think on that front, there is a lot that needs to be done with PVS Sindhu and with so many women coming up and getting the medals. So we like to talk about women in sports, but I don't know how many of us, even as family members or as a society, what are we doing to help women come in sports, you know? Like, it took me a good 3 years to come in a pair of shorts before my coach. I used to feel it's sacrilege, you know, not to, but in kettlebell sports, you need to have a lifting gear. You can't, like, your legs have to be seen so that they know that, you know, the repetition is a proper repetition. So I think both in terms of the mindset of the society and infrastructure awareness, there is a long, long, long way we need to go.
I would like to tell the viewers that Shivani resides in Calcutta, right? Kolkata, you stay in Kolkata.
Yes.
And but I guess this must be the scenario in the entire country, not only in a particular state, because again, as we said, kettlebell is a sport that is still not very much known in the country. So what other challenges did you face at that time, or do you continue to face even now?
In terms of other challenges, honestly, I've been a very self-satiated So my coach always tells me one thing, that, you know, you have to compete with your own self. So in terms of any support from the society, in terms of like the government, etc., we've never gone out that way to seek any support. But in terms of challenges, I'll say that all the male athletes, you know, when we work as a team, like we were a contingent of 4 athletes who went to Uzbekistan, and out of them, 3 were men. And they were extremely supportive and made sure that, you know, I was not made to feel out of place. You can imagine the plight of a conservative Marwari girl traveling with four men. You know, I mean, that was one of a kind of its experience. And so there I would say that we've been very privileged enough. But in terms of other challenges, the sport is such, Varda, that, you know, you are your own competition. You set your own benchmark. And if you really need to be good at the game, there is a lot of investment in terms of strategy, your endurance, your conditioning that you need to work on. One very important aspect of kettlebell lifting, whether you pursue it as fitness or as a sport, is to have a proper coach. I know of so many people, of the few who lift kettlebells, who've lifted it for a year and just given it up because they've landed themselves with an injury. So to all the viewers, I'd say whoever looks at any form of lifting, never do it without the guidance of a coach or a guy or a lady for that matter who's good at that job. So I think I was very lucky to chance upon a mentor, a coach, you know, who paved the way for me. Very great, aspect in them. They can make you learn without being cynical. So I think that on that front, I was very lucky. But as I said, infrastructure, like we don't have training halls, we don't have parks, we don't have places where we can just go and train. You know, everything has to be built by you. So I think that is one challenge we face. But I think by and large, the few athletes that we are in India, we're very used to it by now.
You have already mentioned that you are a chartered accountant by profession. You are also a mom. Yes. So how do you balance work and then sports and also your home?
So I believe in this concept of four wheels of life, Varda, which I share with all the time with the participants in any interview of this kind or a session. So just like a car cannot move without, you know, four wheels. If you remove a car, a wheel from a four-wheeled car, you know, what will happen to the car? Likewise, you know, there are the four wheels of life. One is your professional life. I'm very blessed that I can pursue a profession other than my passion because I'm not paid to lift. My bread, my butter, and my jam comes from my CA practice. I have the privilege of being a national faculty for GSC, for the Institute of Chartered Accountants. Hold very prestigious positions at offices of various chambers of commerce and industry. So that was, where I got the first flavor of success was my CA practice. So that is my professional life. My family life is my husband, my son, my parents, you know. So there again, every woman, you know, looks out at family, and that's one aspect that you should take care of. The third is your social life. When you meet people, you meet friends and, you know, interact and maybe hang out on weekends. And the fourth important wheel of life, which most women, especially Indian women, forget to invest time in, is your personal life. So the only time my phone goes on aeroplane mode is when I'm lifting, you know. And even then, my son may be howling his lungs out. This I'm talking about when he was 3 or 2. And even now, if he's got a class which I need to attend to, but and needs my help, he knows that mama will not be available because right now she's training. Because that is my personal life. That is what I say. It's the me time. You know, that one thing that gets me a lot of joy and satiation. So I think I am very clear that I need to work on these four wheels of life and things will fall in place. It's all about prioritizing, Varda. You know, I never believe in this concept that you don't have time. It's never about having time. It's always about making time.
And how long do you spend? I mean, how long do you practice?
Well, I see with kettlebell, what happens, Varda, if I can show you, you know, what happens if you can see there is a tear here and my palms are torn here also. So, So what happens is that in kettlebell sports, what happens is that whenever you are lifting, there is a lot of wear and tear on your palm. So when you are lifting, you need to strategize your lifting. You can't be lifting all the time because ultimately you'll end up with torn palms. So, as I said, a coach there helps a lot because then there is a lot of planning that gets into your schedule. So for me, my training is 6 days a week, out of which 2 days is assistance training, which is a lot of running. And 4 days a week is kettlebell lifting, which runs into 2 hours every session.
And is there any dietary plan or?
Yes. So I can't consume white sugar. That's an absolute no. No white sugar for me and no gluten. Like it's been 2-3 years, I think, I've not had gluten. So no bread, no pastries, no pizzas, no biscuits. It's been ages. Like, you know, I was a girl who used to get up, have a cup of milk tea with sugar, masale wali chai, and with 2 Mari biscuits, thinking that, you know, these 2 biscuits would really do no harm. And today here I am. I start my day with a cup of liquor tea with stevia. No milk, because I need to maintain a 13-hour fasting state. So, you know, milk releases sugar in your body. So you can't have milk tea in the morning. And no biscuits. I haven't seen what biscuits look like in the longest now.
And we would like to hear some experience of any of your international event that you can never forget. Some interesting event that even now when you think of, you know, that there is a smile on your face. Can you please share it with the viewers?
So as I said, Varda, you know, like I tasted my first success back in 2000, when I was all of 19, you know, when I became a chartered accountant. So that is working for yourself and you start earning money and the people and colleagues know you for the good work you do. But this work you do for yourself, you know. But when I started lifting and my coach told me that the world championship is taking place at Uzbekistan is when I got my gold, and it made me the first woman athlete from India to get gold. And when I was called out at the podium and when they, you know, they gave me the flag around me and when they played the national anthem, I mean, that is something like even now when I speak, I start getting goosebumps. So I think like the national anthem being played in a crowd where 22 countries have participated and, you know, your national flag is held high. I think that experience in itself was like, I have such vivid recollection of that. Like, I think no moment can come close to that. Like,
that
was one of the most beautiful moments I've experienced as a person.
I mean, when we watch our players do wonders and stand on the podium and receive the medals, we ourselves feel so proud and so overwhelming it is. The experience is something that we cannot even tell in words. I can imagine how it must be for the player who is standing there and who has really worked hard and got that medal for the country. Indeed, it's beautiful. And please tell us, Shivani, about your upcoming event. We would like to know. Which event you are going to participate now?
So there are by and large 2 to 3 world organizations in kettlebell sports, one of them being IKMF, the International Kettlebell Marathon Federation. So the world championship has been announced in France from the 25th to the 28th of November this year. And in fact, they just opened up the registrations yesterday. So I would be participating in that and intend leaving somewhere around that time and have the fortune yet again to represent the country. I would be lifting in a 30-minute format wherein you have to continuously lift the bell for 30 minutes without dropping the bell or keeping it down. If you keep the bell down, even on the 29th minute, 59th second, you are disqualified. That's one. And secondly, I'll be lifting a 16 kg half snatch category, and I'm attempting something called an MS. MS is a master of sports, wherein you need to lift the bell for a certain number of repetitions. So if I manage doing that in a span of 30 minutes, which is some about going at an RPM of a little more, less than 16, that's how I get my MS ranking. And if I do that, I become the only woman athlete from India to get an MS in the open category. So I'm really, really looking forward to that. We are putting in a lot of blood and sweat. And this is one sport where I cannot deny that we actually put in blood, because when you're, you know, lifting for a period of 20 minutes, 30 minutes and the palms there, you know, you have blood oozing out from every part of your palm. So just to bolta na khoon paseene ki kamai, that is really happening. So let's see. But we are very excited. And I think we'll be a contingent of about 6 players overall this time. So let's see how it goes.
Shivani, I mean, we would like to know for those youngsters who would like to take this sport up, what advice would you like to give?
See, I would just say one thing, Varda, that you need to be very clear in your goals. to all the youngsters, to all the parents, I'd say, firstly, it's very important for you to get a mentor, even for yourself as a parent or for your child, because the mentor paves the way and helps you, you know, walk on that direction that you don't even know exists for you. Ultimately, you've got to walk the path, but a mentor helps you to understand how to walk that path. And secondly, I always believe in one thing, Varda, that if you are persistent, you will get it. If you are consistent, you will keep it. I got my second gold at Australia in 2019. Had I just shifted loyalties that ek bar kar liya ho gaya, now let's do some other sport, and now let's do some other sport, I think that never helps. I think being consistent and persistent is the key.
Can you please also tell us, I'm quite inquisitive to know how many events and where exactly have you participated, and also tell us about your medals so that we all know about it.
So I have participated in two world championships, which was, and world championships cannot be done virtually. So one was in Uzbekistan, which got India's first gold by a woman athlete in 2018. The second world championship was Melbourne in 2019. These are my two world championships. Barring this, I participated in Malaysia, which was an Asian championship. This was in 2017. Barring this, we participated in a lot of international events which have been conducted online ever since COVID struck. We have a lot of these competitions organized by the English Kettlebell Association, by the Kettlebell Association in Europe, etc., and a ton of national competitions. So I think my coach always tells me that you should have a room dedicated to your medals and your certificates and all your, mementos. I just tell him, sir, that if I start doing that, probably I'll need to build a new house. So, there have been quite a few of them now.
Thank you so much, Shivani, for giving us your time, and we wish you all the best, and we would really want you to, and pray that, you know, you win this MS and make India proud. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
And the viewers,
thank you.
Thanks for watching, and stay safe, stay healthy. Thank you, Shivani.
Thank you. Thank you, Varda. Thank you so much.